You're doing some sparring. You did your last session before Phoenix. What does that go like? What does that entail?
You know, I have done that for a few years. When I was younger, I used to do that a lot. I always liked it. Honestly, I do it more for the physical aspect.
Yeah.
I think it's an amazing workout. I do several different things during the week as a workout, and you know, sparring, boxing, fighting a little bit is one of them. I just feel like the workout aspect of it is like nothing else. So I enjoy it. It's fun.
So I mean, someone gets into you on the track, like, should they be running from you? Like, you know what to do?
Yeah, but you know, I know a little bit, but you never try to use those kind of things unless it's necessary. But you know, it's like having something in your back pocket just in case.
Yeah, exactly. I've seen Daniel Suarez have some moves here at the racetrack a couple of times.
Punches were thrown.
Another thing I saw on social media, I'm the same way. Not very into getting your blood drawn. I saw that. What was the deal with that?
That's a big red flag for me. that time didn't happen, but the previous to that time that I did it, I've actually passed out.
Oh my God.
You know, I'm a lady when it comes to that kind of stuff. You know, I just can't handle those things. I have learned to be better, not to look to the needle, not to look to the blood, but the second I look at it and I see what's going on, game over. So I have to be smart and look somewhere else.
Yeah, you need someone to distract you, you know, take your mind off of it.
I need a Coke, man. Honestly, Coke is
really?
My sponsor, Coca-Cola. They're amazing. I love them. But when it's blood time, I need a Coca-Cola right there, ready, cold and ready.
Because that's not even a sponsor thing. It's just like,
no,
Coke
real.
Is the best.
You need it.
Yeah. That's good. I saw you got a Christmas tree in the background too. Like, it's November. You guys already set up?
Yeah, I need to bring Julia over here so you can talk to her about it.
That's her fault?
Yeah, it's her fault. She loves Christmas. My mom does as well. My mom actually in Mexico, she has Christmas inside the house and she has Halloween outside the house in October. So you know, it's a big deal. They love it. And November 1st, they're already decorating everything on Christmas.
Already ready. Yeah, you going home for Christmas this year?
I do, yeah. You know, I'm going to spend a few weeks over there with my friends and family. So yeah, I'm excited for that.
Nice. Any other off-season plans before we, I mean, I know the off-season, sure, you got to get all that. You know, time in. What
do
you got?
This off season is actually different than every other one because we have a lot of testing. Next week we're gonna be testing the next gen. The following week we're gonna be testing the next gen. In the middle of December we're gonna be here in Phoenix testing the next gen. So the off season is gonna be very, very short with all this testing, which is good. You know, there is a lot of new things and we have to try to start 2022 with one step ahead. But that is making the vacation time already shorter. But it's fine. I still have a few weeks to spend home.
I saw the next-gen car you guys tested at the Roval. Are we going with the chrome numbers for next year? Is that official? You're just trying it out?
I don't know. Honestly, I don't really know. I know people love it. I know people was getting crazy with the design that we had. I don't know what is going to happen. I know that we're going to have some very cool, crazy sponsors for next year that I'm excited about. Who knows? Maybe we do.
Maybe we do from Daniel Suarez. Well, listen, you got to take a break over the offseason. You got the testing, but it's good to see Daniel here at the racetrack. A lot of fun stuff to come for him and the Trackhouse team in 2022.